sana. Asante. Steve, I see a picture. You want to tell us something about Genesis chapter 1 verse 6? Okay, sorry, there was a picture. You noticed that, huh?
Yeah.
Yes. You have quite a radical idea about Genesis 1:26. Tell us about it.
Yeah. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Yeah. The picture is back. As you can see in the picture, there are two gentlemen and there's what seems like a forest in the background and a clearing in the foreground. That is not a forest, believe it or not. It's what we call a green desert, my friends and I. That is a plantation of commercial trees.
Okay.
So what is happening in that picture is that that is Bahati Forest that is supposed to stretch from Nakuru to Nyeri. It has been cleared and then commercial plantations are put there and you get what we call a green desert.
Oh, wow.
Now, why is it a green desert? Because you have only like two or three species of plants that are there, and that cannot support life, the rich biodiversity that a forest supports.
Mm.
So the gentleman in a cap is called Mr. Wahome. He's the owner of Wendo Retreat and Arboretum. He has partnered with Kenya Forestry Service to reforest the clearing.
Okay.
Like the plantations are cleared, then he comes and plants the indigenous forests.
Mm.
Now, Genesis 1:26. It's where the first board meeting in all history happens. God talks to himself and says, I'm going to make a species that is going to be in charge of all other species.
Mm.
That is humans. So our core business as humans is to take care of the environment. We are hardwired by the creator.
Mm.
So like personally, like Steve, I should not introduce myself and say, I'm Steve, my core business is a husband, a lover, a parent. No. I should start by saying, I am Steve. I am a human, first of all, hardwired by the creator to be, to take care of his environment.
Wow.
Then, incidentally, I happen to have a helper who God God brought into the picture.
Yes.
To help me take care of the environment.
Yes.
And we have offspring who we are bringing up to take care of the environment.
We.
Because we only have one planet, and without the planet, there's no family to love.
Okay, yeah. Thank you very much. I think to give this a whole context, April 22nd happens to be Earth Day, and here at Mamlakam, MI3, which falls under Adults Ministries, together with Young Adults, and in also conjunction with the missions, we are planning for something very important. You know that we're to go and plant trees in Bahati Forest, and that's part of the reason why we are having this talk about us being a species that take care of our environment. McKenna, one of the things that we cannot be able to ignore at Mamlaka Hill Chapel is the fact that it is 65% young adults. So what are young adults doing about Earth Day on the 22nd of April?
Okay, good morning.
Morning.
Young adults is Timam Ministry.
Sure.
So what are we doing? I was part of the people who did this last year.
Okay. The planting of trees?
Yes.
Okay.
So there was a pilot and we went and planted trees at the same place.
Mm.
And it was amazing to see how God just used us to impact the environment, but at the same time there's a community there.
Okay.
So this community, we had a chance to talk to them, to just even share the gospel with them.
Okay.
So at the core of what we're doing this year in Timam is to promote our intimacy with God.
Okay.
By linking ourselves with God, of course, our creator, with each other, and with the local community, or with the society.
Sure.
So, basically, how we come in is we want to go as Timam,
okay,
just to plant trees, impact the environment,
okay,
and at the same time, have a time to bond,
okay,
retreat, reflect, and also share the gospel with those who are in the community.
Okay,
yes,
fantastic.
That's
so
our intention.
That's the intention. So,
yes,
we have got the men. We've got Timam, and then missions. How does missions come into all this?
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Isaac.
Yes.
Good morning, church.
Morning.
This is how missions comes in. Besides Mamlaka Chapel being very heavily involved in missions, this opportunity grants us a perfect opportunity to be faithful witness.
Okay.
In this sense,
we
are very heavily involved. The community, the local community, will be very heavily involved into this.
Okay.
Not just a hit and run thing,
but
in the long term, because the community will be heavily involved in the planting of the seeds,
okay,
That's the seed sampling.
Okay.
And also the preparation of the ground where we'll be planting, mm-hmm. and also the material day where we are planting, mm-hmm. the community will also be very heavily involved.
Okay.
And even after we leave, okay. The community will be very heavily involved in watering the seeds for them to grow. And all this process will take like more like 1 to 2 years.
Okay. So it's not a hit and run.
It's not a hit and run. Mm-hmm. And that presents for us a perfect opportunity for authentic relationships to be formed.
Okay.
And these relationships for us provide a perfect opportunity for us to be faithful witness in terms of sharing the gospel mm-hmm. with the community and with all the team that have been in we are doing this in collaboration.
Okay.
What a perfect opportunity for us to talk about the Creator uh-huh. when we're interacting with the creation.
Okay.
And that for us is a faithful opportunity for us. We want to plug in and do our best
okay.
to be found faithful in that.
Amen. Sawa. Yes, you can appreciate Ken for that. Steve, I'd like you to move a little bit forward here. And how can I be able to plug in as a Mamlakite? What do you want me to do?
Okay, Mamlakites, good morning again. Just morning. To make sure we are together. Mm. We are looking for minimum 70 Mamlakites to come to the info desk, sign up, and engage in this activity. The tree planting event will be 1,500 shillings, exclusive of transport
okay.
for the event itself on the material day. It's a whole day of planting mm-hmm. with the local community, sharing a lunch snack with them, and then leaving afterwards after praying for the trees and for the country. Okay. They'll take care of those trees for 2 years because a tree is like a baby. You can't okay. give birth to a man or a woman. In the same way, you can't plant a tree. You actually plant a sapling.
Ah.
Then it takes 2 years to... yeah, it takes 2 years to establish. So we leave the local community there, mm. taking care of the saplings for 2 years. Then if you want to camp over, Wendell has graciously given us good rates. It's only 2,000 shillings. It will cover your supper, your breakfast, and your lunch the next day.
Okay.
In between lunch and, breakfast and lunch, we'll have a mini service because we'll be away from church, and we will discuss further the environmental concern
okay.
and how it affects us.
Okay.
So you're all welcome. Please do not send someone.
Ah.
Come. You are a human, so do not send someone. Unless it's extraneous circumstances, I know Percy is looking at me, my time is over. But unless it's extraneous circumstances
yes.
where you totally cannot come, the only valid reason that you have is that you'll be planting trees elsewhere
okay.
and you can't come to Wendo.
Okay.
But if you can't come at all, please sponsor the students. They have signed up en masse from campus, and they are raising part of their support. They are looking for the rest of their support.
Sure.
Final statement, passing, please.
And the layer.
Yeah. Valentine's Day, you know the way you can't send someone on Valentine's Day. Go talk to my spouse, tell them I love them.
Yes.
Because I'm busy. You put down everything for the sake of one person. Now for Earth Day,
yes.
which is 22nd of April,
yes.
Most of us didn't even know it exists.
Yes.
You take the same initiative and
yes.
push down everything for
yes.
the sake of 7 billion people on this planet.
Yes.
Those forests affect all of us equally. So please come. Don't send anyone. Please come.
Amen. Thanks. Thank you very much. Fantastic.